to be honest, that's it. What's up everyone, and welcome back to the channel to this short and sweet video on quite an important topic, which is the master bus compressor. And I'm not going to spend too much time discussing the issue. I'm just going to delve into it and show you what I do to add that final layer of glue to a mix. And this is mainly what I do for compression on mastering. This is probably the first process that I apply once I have a mix done in a separate session. So I mainly use the SSL stereo comp. And the reason for that is, obviously it sounds good. The people at Waves managed to do an amazing plugin. I've never used a SSL console myself, but it just sounds good. So I don't know if it's accurate to the original or not, but it sounds amazing. And it has very few controls, so there's not that much you can do to mess things up. And the way I set it up is, I just put it on 2. I don't want a lot of compression happening. Large ratios are something I use for other purposes. Maybe if I just do a parallel drum compression. But for this type of thing, I just want it short. I just want it low. And I want to maintain as much as the as much as I can from the transients of the kick and the snare. So I keep the attack as high as it can go, in this case 30 milliseconds, and I kind of do the same with the release. I sometimes go for auto or even 10 milliseconds, but it kind of depends on the song, and we'll see in this case kind of what I decide. And with the threshold, I just play around until I find that it goes to about 2, or in some in more extreme cases 4. You don't want to overcompress, and this doesn't have a sidechain, so it reacts to everything, including that low end, so that kind of sucks a lot of the energy from the compressor anyway, so you don't want it to do a lot. So I'm just gonna hit play on this part of the song, and it's a song I did with Electric Tuxedo a while back called Kaleidoscope with Rocco. So it features both samples in the drum, but also acoustic instruments, so acoustic drums, acoustic snares. So all of this needs to be taken into account when you add compression. If you only have samples, there's not that much of a reason to add compression, but with something like this, yeah, you need to. And since it's acoustic instruments, you kind of need to maintain those transients as well. So I'm just gonna hit play and let's see what it sounds like without any processing. Flying high above an ocean when two drops come even closer, so blue. And I'm gonna turn it on. Flying high above an ocean when two drops come. It's not doing anything now. It's probably adding a bit of gain, but it's barely moving the needle. Flying high above an ocean when two drops come even closer, so blue. Diving deep in the emotion, my reflection's taking over, so new. Fireflies around us in slow motion, shining bright tonight. So I hope you can hear that on auto, it kept everything a bit too contained. So I think I'll go for 0.3 seconds. I like that threshold. And I can clearly hear the kicks and the snares using this. I'll also put it on the fastest setting, just so you can hear the difference. Flying high above an ocean when two drops come even closer, so blue. Obviously it's compressing way more, so let's try and get it to kind of the same level. Flying high above an ocean when two drops come even closer, so blue. And to my ears, it's pumping a bit too much. I wouldn't necessarily use something like this for the mix bus. So although a pretty popular attack time is 1 millisecond, which Andy Wallace uses. So he kind of uses a 1 millisecond and then an auto release. So let's see what that sounds like. High above an ocean when two drops come even closer, so blue. Diving deep in the emotion, my reflection's taking over, so new.
Flying high above an ocean when two drops come even closer, so blue. Diving deep. Flying high above an ocean when two drops come even closer, so blue. Diving deep in the emotion, my reflection sticking over so new.
The difference is subtle, but it does a lot to blend kind of the instruments, the synths, the pianos, all of the stuff that is not a drum, essentially, and maybe not a bass, and just makes it fit with the rest of the instrumentation. So let's try my original setting. Let's see what that sounds like. And actually, let's do a before and after of that.
Flying high above an ocean when two drops come even closer, so blue. Diving deep in the emotion, my reflection sticking over so new. Fireflies surround us in slow motion, shining bright tonight. All that's left to do is dance until our dreams take. Flying high above an ocean when two drops come even closer, so blue. Diving deep in the emotion, my reflection sticking over so new.
I think I like this setting more. I think it feels more open, and I think it lets all of those hits in the drum kind of breathe a bit more. And to be honest, that's it. So obviously you can do a lot of stuff afterwards in terms of mastering the track, but having this on just brings that extra layer of glue to the mix and just makes everything ready for other processes, and also it makes it a bit more translatable to all of the different mediums that we use to listen to, be they phones or cars. So that's it for this week. Next week I'm gonna go into how to EQ post-compression again for mastering. See you then.
Thanks a lot for watching the video until the end. I really do hope you got something out of it. And if you did enjoy it, if you did get any value out of it, please let me know in the comments below. And consider subscribing to the channel, share the video, like it, all that jazz. And I hope to see you next time. Thanks.